When it comes to LED strip lighting, there are two very different styles. On TikTok, you've got highly exposed, bare, flashing LED strips, and pretty much everyone else wants soft diffuse light with no hotspots and no visible LED dots. The best way to get that second look is with LED diffuser channels, but with those, you've got so many choices to make. Is black or aluminum better? What about deep or shallow? Does the shape of the plastic cover matter? And what LED strip density should you use? If all that sounds a little bit overwhelming, don't worry. Answers to all those questions and a lot more are coming up today on The Hookup. As I said, if you've ever looked on Amazon for LED diffuser channels, you know there are a ton of different vendors, styles, and colors. But are those things really important? To answer that question once and for all, I spent a few hundred dollars to get basically every variation of LED diffuser channel and every LED strip density to figure out which combination gives you the most diffuse light with the smallest amount of brightness reduction for the least amount of money. For channel types, we've got shallow unfinished aluminum, deep unfinished aluminum, deep black aluminum, 45 degree deep unfinished aluminum, and 45 degree shallow unfinished aluminum. Then for diffusers on our flat channels, we've got flat milky white, curved milky white, flat smoky black, and this unique tall milky white diffuser. And on our 45 degree channels, we've got milky white flat and milky white curved. The general rule that I've always heard is that to avoid individual bright spots, your LEDs should be further away from the diffuser than they are from each other. And most LED strips come in three different densities: 30 LEDs per meter, 60 LEDs per meter, and 144 LEDs per meter. So right away, it seems like it might be close to impossible to get a completely diffused look from the 30 LEDs per meter variety, since if we use that general rule, our diffuser would need to be over 32.5 millimeters tall. But there's only one way to find out for sure, so let's get testing. First, let's look at deep versus shallow channels. Starting out with 30 LEDs per meter, you can see the shallow channel on the left and the deep channel on the right. And as we would expect, the deep channel does a significantly better job diffusing light at each brightness level. But the dots are still very visible. At 60 LEDs per meter, the deep channel is really close to achieving that perfectly diffused look, and at 144 LEDs per meter, the hotspots are gone. So for the most diffuse look, there's no question that deep channels are significantly better than shallow channels, but there is a drawback. I also measured the drop in brightness compared to no diffuser at all, and on average, the deep channel led to a 36% drop in brightness versus only a 22% drop in brightness for the shallow channel. So if you're just looking for a channel to conceal or mount your LEDs, then shallow channels are still the way to go. Next, let's look at channel color. I've got two identical channels, one black and one bare aluminum. And for control, we're gonna use the flat diffuser on both of them. On the left is the black channel, and on the right is the bare aluminum channel. And you can see that at 30 LEDs per meter, neither of them completely diffuse the LED strips, but the black channel is significantly dimmer than the bare aluminum. At 60 LEDs per meter, the unfinished aluminum does a slightly better job at diffusing while maintaining better brightness, and the same is true for 144 LEDs per meter. According to my measurements, the average brightness reduction for the black deep channel with the flat diffuser was 58% versus just 36% brightness reduction for the bare aluminum channel with the flat diffuser. Moral of the story, unless you really need it for your aesthetic, avoid the black channels in favor of the bare aluminum ones. Next, let's look at diffuser shapes. I've got three different diffuser shapes to test: a flat diffuser that sits flush with the top of the channel, a curved diffuser that the manufacturer calls their spotless diffuser, which sits above the channel but also has a thicker area near the middle of the curve. And then I've got what I call the tented diffuser that stands up above the channel to give additional height and provide some side profile light as well. Unfortunately, the tented diffuser only fits on the shallow channel that it came with, so I can't test the deep channel with the tented diffuser. Starting out with 30 LEDs per meter, we've got the bare aluminum deep channel with a flat diffuser on the left, and the same bare aluminum deep channel with the spotless diffuser on the right. At 50% and 100% brightness, the spotless diffuser doesn't disappoint and gives as close to a spotless look as we can expect from a 30 LED per meter strip. Switching it out for 60 LEDs per meter, the spotless diffuser does it again and lives up to its name, giving us the first time we've seen a completely spotless look through all of the colors and all the brightness levels. Unfortunately, I couldn't find a place to purchase the spotless diffuser with the shallow channel, but for comparison's sake, here's what that combination looks like at 30 and 60 LEDs per meter, which, although is not perfect, is a huge improvement over the flat diffuser. Next, let's see how the deep channel with the spotless diffuser compares to the tented diffuser. At 30 LEDs per meter, the advantage definitely goes to the spotless diffuser, But at 60 LEDs per meter, it's a bit of a toss-up, because even though the spotless diffuser on the right does a slightly better job giving the completely spotless look, it does cause a brightness reduction of 56% versus just 35% reduction on the tinted diffuser. Plus, the tinted diffuser also gives some side profile light, which I think looks pretty cool. At 144 LEDs per meter, they both look completely spotless, but as expected, the tinted diffuser is significantly brighter. Last, just for completeness, let's quickly cover LED diffuser colors. On some listings, you might see the option of milky white or smoky gray diffusers, but in my testing, I wouldn't even call the smoky gray version a diffuser. It does hide the LED strip when the power isn't on, but you can see that once they do turn on, the entire strip and every LED is visible. On the left is 60 LEDs per meter with a deep black channel and smoky gray diffuser, and on the right is the deep black channel with a milky white diffuser. The craziest part about this is that they both result in about the same amount of brightness reduction, which is around 58%, despite a significantly lower diffusion. So it's time for some conclusions and recommendations. The sweet spot for LED density in terms of price, power consumption, and aesthetic is definitely 60 LEDs per meter. And my two favorite diffusers to use with those strips are the shallow aluminum channel with the tinted diffuser and the deep aluminum channel with the spotless diffuser. Between the two, the spotless diffuser is slightly more spotless, but the tinted diffuser looks better when it's off, has a better mounting system, less brightness reduction, and also gives the side profile light that I think looks really good. 30 LED per meter strips, on the other hand, are really hard to completely diffuse. And if you're using them for indirect light, then no diffuser is still best because that's going to give you the most brightness. But if you do want to conceal them, then a shallow channel with a flat diffuser results in the smallest amount of brightness reduction. If you absolutely need to use the 30 LED per meter density in a visible location, then the bare aluminum deep channel with a curved spotless diffuser did by far the best job reducing hotspots, but with still less than perfect results and a 56% decrease in brightness. All these same principles also apply to the 45 degree channels, except that the curved diffuser version doesn't have the thicker part near the center like the spotless diffuser does, and as a result, it doesn't work quite as well. Still, the curved diffuser does a significantly better job than the flat diffuser, but neither of them are able to achieve a completely spotless look with 30 or 60 LEDs per meter, and the flat diffuser couldn't even do it with 144 LEDs per meter. If you were wondering, I did pay full price for all these diffusers on Amazon, and as always, there are no sponsored reviews on my channel. However, the links down in the description are affiliate links, so if you appreciate the time and effort that it takes me to make videos like this and you want to show some thanks, then go ahead and use those links because I do get a small portion of the sale at no cost to you. Thank you so much to all of my patrons over at Patreon for your continued support of my channel, and if you're interested in supporting my channel, please check out the links down in the description. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the thumbs up button and consider subscribing, and as always, thanks for watching The Hookup.